What is going on, guys? This is Zayden coming back at you with some more Dark Souls. It's been a few days since I've recorded an episode. I've had a lot on my plate. And to anybody who is actually following the series, which aren't many, I am sorry if that's caused you any duress. But I've had a lot on my plate. I had a friend who needed a hand with some things in life. And then today, so right now it is, technically it's the 24th, but it's 1:10 in the morning. So, recording this episode being late since the 23rd, where I went to my late father's house to collect some belongings. He passed quite a while ago. It's a hard thing to face, going through someone who loves belongings. So, it has been a while. But, we're going to be playing some Dark Souls, and Dark Souls makes everything better. Why did I two hit that? I am dumb. Oh yeah, we're going grass. Damn it. Wow. That crotch shot. Nice statue. So, between last episode and this episode, there was some grinding that I did. You can see that I look different. I basically went down. I went back to Sens, killed Rickard. And I went and murdered the leeches in Blighttown repeatedly, farmed for some Titanite, just to upgrade a few things. And then I talked to Frampt and broke down the green Titanite shards, except for 10 of them. So I have a bunch of regular Titanite shards now. That angle much. That's also why I have 10 humanity at the moment. So if you look at the chain there, this one's pointing at me, and this one is pointing away from me. The ones that are pointing away from you are perfectly safe. And then also, if we just kind of angle the camera here, and wait, there we go. You can see that the chest starts breathing. Or care to, for that matter. I think we have enough souls to level up now. Hmm.
You are a rare visitor. Welcome to the lost city of Anor, Londo, chosen undead. If you seek Lord Gwyn's old keep, exit here and head straight yonder. If you are the chosen one, a revelation shall visit thee. What follows thereafter depends upon you. What is it? What am I? Well, I am the keeper of the bonfire. If not for me, what beacon would there be in this lost city? A gatekeeper and a guide. That is my calling. The bonfires attended by the keepers are special. They are linked to one another, and their flames never die. Yet never shall the keepers of these flames meet. If you require rest, now is the time. That is, after all, what the bonfire is for. If you require...
Alright. So if we seek, then we should venture straight yonder. And then a revelation shall visit us, apparently. Be like that. You're just a big jerk. Got it. So the first time that I played through Dark Souls, I actually had to look up what to do here. The revelation didn't hit me at all. You know, she spoke of a revelation, I had none. So I had to look up how to get to here. I guess I just didn't expect something so incredibly convoluted. There we go. I also did get the Eido and the Eagle Shield while I was in Blighttown. God, if three hits him. That's not acceptable. Not when this one hits. Huh, can't break it with a bow. Interesting. All right, so if you get these guys right about here, they jump off. Just a little glitch in their pathing. They think that they can jump attack you because they're in range for it, but they don't account that there's nowhere to stand. Okay, Mr. Knifey. Holy jeez. The RNG on this guy. Oh, man. Too good. That is not me being invaded. That is somebody texting my phone. I'm aware that there's a jump you can do right here. I've just never been good at it, so I don't do it. Just give me one moment here. Just replying to a buddy of mine who I'm gonna be trucking with. Hope that you guys don't mind anybody watching this. I don't normally make a habit of it, but I have set plans that I'm trying to adhere to. So if there's a few breaks here in the episode where I stop and text and don't edit it out, please do not take it personally. Oh no. Just telling me you can come on over. There we go. So that should be good. No! Oh. Oh no. Mine elevator. 27.9. 28.8. 30. Such a pain in the ass. All right. Good job. Okay, nice, McGee. Yeah, we get it. You have knives. You like throwing them. Good job. Score one for Knives McGee. And again, a very good job to you, sir. There we go. Very just slow, methodical player. I don't really take risks. And I understand that to a lot of people that's not the most exciting. I think it'll lend itself better when I'm playing Dark Souls 2 and 3, because those will be at least mainly blind. I haven't been very far. I haven't found a single great soul in Dark Souls 2 before. So most of the game is blind to me. And I've barely been through any of Dark Souls 3. The axe and the shield and the helmet. I think that's everything for the gargoyle set. Whilst I am here, I believe that it's this way for down. You push it towards the way that you want the staircase to go. So I pushed it towards the down part of the staircase to push it down, and push it towards the top end of the staircase to push it towards the top. I just wanted to light that bonfire. Not actually gonna sit at it at all. But later on, it'll be useful for teleporting. That was cool. I enjoyed that. I was holding my shield. I should have rolled. Wasn't holding it long enough, apparently. Not good. to be. Dodge. Okay. Only one way to do this. Nope. That did not work. At all. Alright, so let's get back to our little soul blot there. Such a nice view. I really do like Anor, Londo. Doing that just for the lightning defense. Disadvantage on my part. And the knockback is too big on my chest. Hit. Like these are wooden. Yeah, these are the standard. Stand these off until these guys die, because frankly, I just do not feel like fucking with them. Now, if I could actually hit them, that'd be wonderful. Looks like I'm getting headshots every time on this one. And a lot of luck, and a very, very, very small amount of skill. Mainly luck. Now, one way to do this, if you're having trouble, is you can stand behind the pillar down there. And if you get the right spot, he won't be able to hit you. You just spam poison arrows. Even if he's not taking damage, as long as you can see the arrows hitting him, then you're doing it right. And you just spam arrows at him all the live long day. You have to aim above him, obviously, to account for the drop. Oh. Shit. Son of a bitch! No! Oh, the roll. The roll was bad. The roll was terrible. Oh, the roll was so, so terrible. Ugh. And I missed my elevator. Make attempt number three here. Staircase. I find it kind of cool that they have the regular people staircase and then the giant staircase for like the gods and the sentinels and stuff like that. Alright. You know what? Ain't nobody got time for you. No, I said ain't nobody got time for you. Ass. All done. You suck. I rock. Na 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 boo boo. Alright. So fuck those guys. Plainly and frankly. Fuck them guys. Alright, and we have a bonfire, another point of endurance. We're feeling good about ourselves. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the like button, and we will see you next time.